Any minute now, we are expecting new weekly COVID numbers from the state.
Yeah, this as new data suggests Florida will hit the peak of this latest wave as soon as next week. Researchers also have a potential timeline on herd immunity. News 6's Amanda Castro spoke to one of the scientists behind this study. She joins us now live in the newsroom with more. Amanda.
Yeah, Ginger, based on researchers' current projections, not only could we reach the peak by next week, but we could also reach herd immunity in Florida by mid-September and possibly see an end to the pandemic by early next year. But he cautions there are several factors that could change these predictions, adding now is not the time to drop the ball on vaccinations and safety measures.
Dr. Edwin Michael is a professor of epidemiology and disease modeling at the University of South Florida. His team tracking COVID-19 data and using that information to make projections. He says the latest model shows Florida could reach the peak of this surge by next week on August 24th.
Now we are showing at peak 23,000 cases.
A month ago, his model was showing a higher number of cases and a later peak, 41,000 on September 3rd.
And that is, you know, testament to people, you know, reacting to the news. Their cases are rising.
Dr. Michael credits the drop in projected cases due to an increase in vaccinations, mask wearing, and people practicing safety precautions. He says all of that will help the state reach herd immunity faster, saying that's when 90% of the state's population has immunity, either after recovering from COVID or from the vaccine.
If the current vaccination rate were to be maintained, you know, and the current social measures were to continue, then we'll reach herd immunity 90% September 11.
He says it's important to reach herd immunity as soon as possible, so there's a smaller population of people who can transmit the virus, as well as prevent future mutations that could make the vaccines less effective. He adds the boosters might help prolong immunity, but he cautions while this looks like good news, now is not the time to let our guard down.
I don't want to, be wildly optimistic, but I'm cautiously optimistic.
And Dr. Michael is encouraging people to continue wearing masks and to get vaccinated. And he adds, if we continue these efforts, then based on his latest projections, he says the pandemic could come to an end in January or February of next year. But he warns if we see additional variants that causes more breakthrough infections in vaccinated people, then we could see more spikes.